Hello, I am Dr. Satishkumar Kashid, Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur, presenting a topic, Application of Unit Hydrograph for Deriving Unit Hydrographs of Different Duration. Learning outcome: at end of this session, students will be able to derive unit hydrographs of different durations using unit hydrograph of given duration. We need hydrographs of different durations. Now these are necessary under conditions where lack of adequate data is there in development of unit hydrograph. A D-hour unit hydrograph is used to develop unit hydrograph of different durations, say that is n times d. It means 2 times d, 3 times d or so. It means we have, suppose, 2-hour unit hydrograph, that is 2 multiplied by 3 times, that is 3 into 2, 6. So we will be able to derive say 6-hour unit hydrograph by using 2-hour unit hydrograph. There are two methods available. First method is method of superposition and second method is the S-curve method. In this small presentation, we will be dealing with the method of superposition. Now what is method of superposition? If a D-hour unit hydrograph is available, it means say we have 2-hour unit hydrograph available and it is desired to develop unit hydrograph of n times d. N can be 2, n can be 3, n can be 4. Then it is easily accomplished by superposing n unit hydrographs with each graph separated from previous by d hours. Example will clarify the things. Now suppose we have d equal to 2, 2-hour unit hydrograph. 2-hour unit hydrograph means what? Whenever there is 1 centimeter rainfall excess in 2 hours. In 2 hours, there is 1 centimeter rainfall excess. This intensity of rainfall was 0.5 centimeter per hour. It rained here for 1 hour. It accumulated half centimeter. In second hour, it again accumulated 0.5 centimeter, totaling to 1 centimeter. So this was 1 centimeter rainfall excess in 2 hours. And due to that, effect of that rainfall over a specific catchment was to produce a hydrograph in this way, which has a base of say 9 hours. And these are the ordinates which are produced by rainfall in a particular stream in form of a stream flow. At one time 1 hour, this is the ordinate. At time 2 hour, this is the ordinate. So peaking time is at 3 hours, say the rainfall, say the stream flow is about say 450 meter cube per second and so on. Now this particular 2 hour unit hydrograph we are going to use further. Now change the unit hydrograph duration. Consider 1 hour unit hydrograph and add lag to unit hydrographs by 1 hour sum and divided by 2, resulting 2 hour unit hydrograph. It means this is 1 hour unit hydrograph . This is another 1 hour unit hydrograph lagged by 1 hour. So what will I have to do? Will have to add the ordinates and divide those by 2, and that will result in 2 hour unit hydrograph. Now we'll take a question. Select appropriate answer. A 3 hour unit hydrograph differs from 6 hour unit hydrograph for any catchment. Options are 4. Both the time of rise and the peak ordinate for the former, that is 3-hour unit hydrograph, are less than that for the latter, that is 6 ordinate hydrograph. Second option, both the time of rise and peak ordinates of the former are greater than that of the latter. Third, the time of rise for 3 hour unit hydrograph is less, but peak ordinate is greater for the former, that is 3 hour, as compared to the latter, that is 6 hour unit hydrograph. Option D is the time of rise is greater, but the peak ordinate is less for the former as compared to that of the latter. The answer is C. The time of rise is less, but peak ordinate is greater for the former. It means for a 3 hour unit hydrograph, we find that 1 centimeter rainfall takes place in 3 hours only. That's why rise will be more for 3 hour unit hydrograph as compared to 6 hour unit hydrograph. Why? Because in second case, 1 centimeter rainfall takes place in long 6 hours. That's why, as time is more, obviously you'll find the rise is lesser for 6 hours, and rise will be more for 3 hours, and you'll find the ordinate is greater for the former because more rainfall in less time. So you'll find ordinate will be greater for 3 hour unit hydrograph as compared to 6 hour unit hydrograph. So this gives us the idea about how hydrographs differ. Now here let us have an example. Given the ordinates of 4 hour unit hydrograph as below, derive the ordinates of 12 hour unit hydrograph from the same catchment. So time hours 0, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, going up to 44. And ordinates of 4 hour unit hydrograph are this: 0 meter cube per second, 20 meter cube per second, 80 meter cube per second. It means due to 1 centimeter rainfall spread over entire catchment in 4 hours, of course 1 centimeter rainfall excess in 4 hours, at the outlet of the catchment we are getting these discharges varying with the time. So this time we are showing 0, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, and so. And then we are given these ordinates of 4 hour unit hydrograph. Right. Now we are doing calculations for 12 hour unit hydrograph from 4 hour unit hydrograph. Means we are given 4 hour unit hydrograph ordinates and we want to derive 12 hour unit hydrograph ordinates. It means time is 3 times. So here what we are doing, in figure I will show, the first 4 hour unit hydrograph starts from 0 and goes up to 44 hours. It will be followed by another 4 hour unit hydrograph, will start from 4, go in this way with these ordinates and go up to 48. In third part will start from 8 and go in this way. So these were lagged by 4 hours. So this is lagged by 4 hours, second 4 hour unit hydrograph. This is lagged by 8 hours, the third unit hydrograph. And then we are adding these ordinates horizontally to get direct runoff hydrograph of 3 centimeter rainfall excess. One due to this, second centimeter due to this, and third centimeter due to this. That is 3 centimeter rainfall excess, and this is the resulting hydrograph. So this was 3 centimeter rainfall excess. So we need to divide these accumulated ordinates again by 3 to get the ordinates of 12 hour unit hydrograph. So these were the ordinates of 12 hour rainfall event with 3 centimeter rainfall excess. Obviously we need to divide those by 3 to get ordinates of 12 hour unit hydrograph in meter cube per second. So in this way, by knowing order rates of 4 orange unit hydrograph, we have calculated ordinates of 12 hour unit hydrograph, which was the objective of this particular lecture. So you will find that when we sum the ordinates of these 3-4 hour unit hydrograph lagged by 4 hours, this is a total. F is equal to A plus B plus C, direct runoff hydrograph of 3 centimeter, and when we divide it by 3, we get the 12 hour unit hydrograph dividing this ordinate by 3, and obviously it is due to 1 centimeter rainfall excess over 12 hours. So in this way we constructed 12 hour unit hydrograph from 4 hour unit hydrograph. These are the references, and thank you.